Good morning, students. So in the previous class, we were started a new lesson, that is lesson number 4, nervous system. Okay, and in this lesson, we have discussed that the definition of nervous system. What is that? The system that controls and coordinates the actions of all the sense organs. That is called as nervous system. Okay, and this nervous system is consist of brain, spinal cord. And next, the last one is nerves. And in the previous class, we have discussed about brain. Okay, so you know that brain is the control center of our body, and this brain is protected by a hard bony structure that is called as skull. Okay, and an adult human brain is about 1.5 kg. Yes, it contains about. Yet what contains? Our brain contains billion of nerve cells, and the brain needs a this brain needs continuous oxygen and blood supply. Okay, if the sufficient blood will not supply to the brain, what will happen? Yes, that man or that person will get faint. So it is very necessary to get continuous, the flow of blood and oxygen is very necessary for the brain. Okay, so and also we must get enough sleep for the proper function of our brain. So these all things we have discussed in the yesterday's class. Today we are going to discuss about the parts of brain. Okay, so let's study about that, parts of brain. Parts of brain. So mainly there are three parts. Mainly there are three parts in the brain. Okay. So what are those? Those are the first one is cerebrum. That is cerebrum. And the next one is cerebellum. Cerebellum. And the third one is modula. Okay, modula. Or this modula is also having one more name, that is called as oblongata. Okay, oblongata. So these are the three important parts of the brain. First one is cerebrum. Next to cerebellum and modula, and for this modula one more name is there, that is called as oblongata. Okay, so let's study all of these parts of the brain one by one. What is first one? What is cerebrum? What is the function of cerebrum? How it works? Let's study about that. Okay, so this among all these, first one is about cerebrum. So what is cerebrum? It is the uppermost and the largest part of the human brain. It is the uppermost. It is the uppermost and the largest. And the largest part. Largest part of the brain. If you see the brain, this cerebrum part is the largest and also it is the uppermost part of the brain, which has folded appearance and is composed of right and left hemispheres. Yes, what it composed? Composed of? It composed of? Composed of right and left. Right and left hemisphere. Is that hemisphere? Hemisphere. And also it receives the message from the sense organs. Yes, the part of this brain is receives the what messages from the sense organs. It receives messages. It receives messages from whom? From the sense organs. From the sense organs. and decides what the body should do. Yes, this part of the brain receives the messages from the sense organs like eyes, nose, mouth, okay, ear, and sense, and they decides, this part decides what should do and what should not do. Okay, the part of the brain, cerebrum, receives the messages from the sense organs and then decides what should do, and it is responsible for learning. Yes, the part of the brain, cerebrum, responsible for the learning, memory, intelligence, speech and logic. For all these things, this part is responsible. For what? See, this is responsible for, first one is learning, next intelligence, and what else? Speech, logic, and memory. For all these things, the cerebrum is the responsible. Okay, so see here, I will explain the things one more time. First one is, there are three parts in a brain. Those are the cerebrum and cerebellum, and the last one is medulla. And for the medulla, one more name is there, that is called as oblongata. Okay, among all of these three parts, we are going to study. The first one is cerebrum. This is the uppermost and largest part of the brain. And what it composed? It composed of right and left hemispheres. And what is received? It receives the messages from whom? From the sense organs, and decides what should do and what should not do. Okay? And next, these are the responsible. Cerebrum is the responsible for the learning, for intelligence, speech, logic and memory. For all these things, the cerebrum is the responsible. Okay? So, this is all about the cerebrum. So, first part of the brain. Okay? So, the next one is cerebellum. It is the second part. The second part of the brain is cerebellum. So let's see, what is this cerebellum? It is situated below the cerebrum. Yes, andre cerebrum first part ittala, aa part kelagade na yen irutha cerebellum irutha. So we can say that it is situated in the sense of present. Yell present irutthidhu, cerebrum kedagade ne present. It is situated below the cerebrum. And the cerebrum kedagade ne idu, cerebellum present agirutta. Next, it coordinates the actions of muscles and also maintain the balance of our body. What it does, what is the use of the cerebellum? First one is, it maintains the balance of our body. Actions of what? It coordinates the actions of muscles. And then muscles actions coordinate. Okay. And also it helps us to run, walk and play. It helps us to run, walk, below the cerebrum. And next, it what it does, it maintains the balance of our body. Nam body balance na agumaga nodkoteti. Okay. And next, it coordinates the actions of muscles. Muscles matta bones nadu en nadittava kelavondu actions nadittava adannella en madutta coordinate madutta. Okay. And next one, it helps us to run, walk and flip. Nam aata adbeku, walk madbeku, ಓಡಬೇಕು, ರನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತಂದ್ರೆ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್? ಸೆರಿಬೆಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್. ನೌ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಮೀ ದಟ್ ಹೌ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ರನ್, ವಾಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಲೆಗ್ಸ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಹೆಂಗಾದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೇನು ಸೆರಿಬೆಲಮ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್, ಮತ್ತು ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ನಡೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಓಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಆಟ ಆಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾಲುಗಳು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಗ್ತಾವಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಅನ್ಬೋ ಕೇಳ್ಬೋದು. ಹೆಂಗೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೆಸೇಜಸ್. ಎಸ್, ಅವರ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೆಸೇಜಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ಗನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಇದೇನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಮೆಸೇಜನ್ನ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ರಿಸೀವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡೆ ನಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತು ಮಾಡಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ನಮಗೇನು ಅರ್ಥ ಮಾಡಿಸುತ್ತೆ, ಏನು ನಾವು ಆಟ ಆಡಬೇಕು, ವಾಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇ, ಆಟ ಆಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ. Okay, this is how it works. So we can say that it also helps us to walk, run and play. Okay, this is all about the second part of the brain, cerebellum. Okay, now the third and the last one, third part of the brain, that is medulla. Oblongata. Okay, no need to write that, just keep this part in your mind. Okay, so what it does, it is the base of the brain. Yes, it is the base of the brain. See, if you see this, the picture of this brain, you will get a idea what this is. This upper side of the brain is called as cerebrum. Yes, cerebrum is the uppermost part of the brain anta helide. So of course it is the upper side, upper part of the brain, so it is the cerebrum. Next, this is the lower side, the lower side part of it is called as cerebellum, and this is the medulla. You can see, yes, where it is present, it is the below kelagade ide. Howda, so that's because you can say it is the base of the brain. Base andre eno kelagade, base elli irutte avagadru, it is below side. Okay, so it is the base of the, it is the base of the brain. Nam brain enirudu base, it is the brain base of the brain, and it connects the brain. Okay, what it does, it connects the brain to the spinal cord. This medulla connects the brain to the spinal cord. It connects the brain to the spinal cord. And then nama brain anna oda edu connect madutiddu spinal cord illa, yaru medulla, cerebellum medulla. In medulla nama brain anna oda spinal cord ge connect madutta. Okay, and it controls the involuntary actions of the body. Yes, this medulla controls our involuntary actions of our body, like heartbeat. Okay, breathing pumping the blood. So all these actions are involuntary actions, in the sense the actions which are not under our control are called as involuntary actions. Heartbeat matte eno breathing, respiration, ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಂಡರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಒಳಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಇವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾವೆ, ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ನಡೆದಿರ್ತಾವ, ವಿದೌಟ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್, ವಿದೌಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಟಯರ್ಡ್. ಹೌದಾ, ಸೊ ಈ ಮೆಡ್ಯುಲ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಏನು ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿದ್ದು, ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಮೆಡ್ಯುಲ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಸ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ವಾಲಂಟರಿ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ಸಚ್ ಆಸ್ ಬ್ರೀತಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ ಬೀಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ಸ್ Involuntary actions of the body. What are the involuntary actions of our body? Like heartbeat. First one is heartbeat. Okay. Second one is what is that? Breathing. Breathing matle heartbeat iruvanta one involuntary actions anna namu enu medulla en madutta control madutta. Okay, next medulla keeps working even when we are asleep. Medulla continuously work madutta. It work continuously without taking sleep also. Now even ankondagu ee medulla en madutta continuously work madutta. Keep it in mind. Okay, medulla keeps working even when we fall asleep. Now mankondagu medulla work maadtirutta. Okay, so this is all about medulla. So what we learnt in today's class, we have learnt that parts of the brain, yes, there are three parts of the brain: cerebrum, cerebellum, and the last one is medulla. And one more name for this medulla is oblongata. Okay, so the remaining part of this, see, some of the questions in the page number 166, you can see this. Fill in the missing letters to name the parts of related to the brain. ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಾರೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಫಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಿಸ್ಸಿಂಗ್ ಲೆಟರ್ಸ್, ಕೆಲವೊಂದು ಲೆಟರ್ಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗ್ಯಾವ, ಎದಕ್ಕೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಅದಾವು ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದು ಲೆಟರ್ಸ್, ಬ್ರೈನಿಗೆ ರಿಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಅದಾವೆ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಅದಾವಿಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ರಿಕಗ್ನೈಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಇನ್ ಯೋರ್ ಹೋಮ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯೋರ್ ಹೋಮ್ ವರ್ಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟುಮಾರೋಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ನರ್ವ್ಸ್. ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ನರ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನರ್ವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆಲ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿ ವಿಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ಟುಮಾರೋಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್.